Hi guys, my name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive magazine. What we have here is the Framus Wolf Hoffman signature. For those of you who don't know, Wolf Hoffman is the lead guitarist for German heavy metal band Accept. And both Accept and Wolf are famous for flying Vs, such as this. Now, for most of his career, Wolf is known for playing the iconic white Gibson flying V, but in recent years, he's moved over to Framus guitars now. Again, for those of you who don't know, Framus are a German guitar manufacturer. And Wolf has put together this signature model with the guys over at Framus. Apparently it happened over a conversation at a party over at Wolf's house where they said, Wolf, we'd love you to play our guitars. To which he replied, well, yeah, okay, if you can build me a really good flying V. And it just so happens, a really good flying V is what we've got. Let's talk about some specs. So, up here at the headstock, first of all, in belt and braces kind of fashion, we have a Floyd Rose locking nut, but we also have, and I'll just show this to the camera, six locking machine heads. Now, those of you familiar with Floyd Roses and the way they work will probably be thinking, well, why bother with locking machine heads if you have a locking nut? My assumption is that it's there to speed up the arduous process of changing your strings when you have a Floyd Rose. Really cool stuff. It's just part of the general over-engineered kind of feel the guitar has. Moving on to the fretboard, what we've got are 24 beautifully shiny, I would say probably medium jumbo frets on this tiger stripe ebony fretboard. Another really cool feature, and I can tell you how valuable this is on dark stages, what we have are glow-in-the-dark side dots. Really rather cool. Now, I'm guessing these are the kind you have to charge up with a light before you go on stage. But believe me, if you've ever been, if you've ever fallen victim to going for the big guitar solo during a blackout on the stage and subsequently throttled your lighting engineer, you will know how valuable these things are. On the front, we have these really cool block and arrowhead inlays. I think you can probably see them pretty clearly. We have this kind of like mother of pearl block and this abalone kind of arrow or arrowhead. Really, really nice, all leading up towards this beautiful truss rod cover. Really, really nice and really kind of premium appointment. And once again, we've got Wolf's signature up there. Really nice. Moving to the body, kind of unusually for a flying V, the body is made of maple, which generally would make the guitar feel very heavy because maple is a heavy solid wood. It also contributes to a snappy overall response. And that's kind of aided and abetted by the 22.5-inch or Fender style scale length. Now, I would expect a maple flying V to wear the earth, but this guitar is actually very, it's a very manageable weight. It's certainly not light by any stretch of the imagination, but it's definitely not backbreakingly heavy. And I think that's due to the contouring. Again, once I'll just show this to the camera, the contouring of the body. It starts off fairly thick around the center, but it actually tapers to kind of a fairly narrow edge. Now, Wolf describes this as being there to kind of give a kind of a nice ergonomic feel to the picking hand. And those of you who know how Wolf plays, he kind of uses the trailing edge of the pick and he's got a bit of an upward pick slant going on. And I can attest to that kind of thing. It does feel really nice. It's nice to lean on. It's got a lovely beveled edge, almost like a Strat, which is kind of cool. In terms of controls, we have a three-way pickup selector, a master volume, no coil cut, no tone, nice and simple. And we have Fishman pickups. We've got a single coil and a humbucker down here. Now, something I'm seeing quite a lot on 24 fret guitars is the idea of using a single coil in the neck position. Big fan of this because it gets you as close to that beautiful 24th fret sweet spot as you can get. A neck humbucker on a 24th fret guitar is usually just a little bit too far over to sound genuinely like neck pickup-ish, if you will. But the single coil here does the trick. Sounds great. And of course, we have a Floyd Rose, made by Floyd Rose for Framus. Got a block on the back, which I'm told, doesn't look it, but I'm told is a brass block. We have three springs and there is no cover on the back, and I'm guessing that's just so you can kind of access it for quick adjustments, and if you want to, you can also make all the Van Halen noises like this. If that's your kind of thing. So anyway, that's the spec. Let's have a listen to some tones. Okay, so while it's customary to start these kind of tonal rundowns with a clean sound, I am guessing, if you're interested in this guitar, that's probably not what you came here to see. So we're gonna start off with some gain. Let's do a Sur Eclipse with the gain set somewhere around 2 o'clock. And we're gonna start with the bridge humbucker. It sounds something a bit like this. And on some single note lines, it sounds like this. Okay, moving right along to the middle position, it's gonna sound something like this. Generally speaking, in a heavy metal context, you probably wouldn't riff out in the middle position. It does sound quite nice on this guitar though, and I think that's something to do with the maple construction and the longer scale length. This is how it sounds. And this selection on single note lines sounds a bit like this. And last but not least, we have the next single coil riffing out once again. This probably wouldn't be your first choice for heavy metal riffs, but we'll try it all the same. Sounds like this. And for single note work, it sounds like this. So while it's probably reasonable to expect that users of this guitar will spend most of their time on the bridge pickup while using lots of distortion, you'll notice the neck pickup's got a really cool bluesy, almost a flutey kind of voice. Really nice for soloing, really nice for kind of breaking things up, perhaps in a verse or a quieter part of a song. Sounds great. I think that's something, again, to do with the positioning of the pickup, but also the single coil is voiced really cleanly and clearly. Now, speaking of clean, let's try this with a clean sound. We're gonna start with the neck position this time. Okay, so moving over to the middle pickup selection, sounds a bit like this. And last but not least, the bridge humbucker. Generally not the first choice for clean arpeggios, but we'll give it a try. Sounds something like this. Okay, so as you can hear, each pickup has a really distinct voice, and in my opinion, each one plays a very distinct role in the way you're gonna use this in a band context. I'm gonna assume it's probably safe to bet that you are going to use the bridge humbucker for most of your distorted guitar duties, with occasional excursions to the neck pickup for bluesier leads. However, when it's time to play clean, perhaps for arpeggio passages, you might switch across to the neck single coil. The bridge humbucker, it works, it's perhaps a little brash for that kind of thing, but that's really what gives it that great quality when it's distorted. If you're playing clean passages and you want natural harmonics to really pop out, you may try both pickups in combination. Personally, I think the strongest clean voice is in the neck position, the strongest distorted voice is in the bridge position, and that's okay. It's really cool. It gives you lots of options, especially for the heavy metal guitarist. Now, the elephant, or the elephant noise in the room that we haven't talked about, is this Floyd Rose. It is incredibly smooth and incredibly stable. You can hopefully see down here, it says Framus by Floyd Rose. So it is a proper legitimate Floyd. It's got a screw collar, which means that the bar stays put. It means you can flutter it nicely. Locks are at the back, which is more of a traditional design as opposed to more modern top locking variants, and I think that's kind of cool. I think it harkens back to the glory days of 80s heavy metal. We have the usual 6 fine tuners with plenty of range. It is incredibly smooth and it sounds something like this. So obviously that is the Floyd Rose under some fairly serious duress. Now, it is capable of much greater subtlety than that, but let's be honest, if you've bought this guitar, subtlety is probably not top of the list of priorities. However, it is actually really quite a versatile instrument. It's capable of a great tonal range. Like I say, it's beautifully finished. It is immaculately playable, very, very well built. Team built in Germany, which is kind of cool. It looks great, but let's be honest, you're probably not going to take it to your jazz gig. It is ostensibly a heavy metal instrument, and it really excels in that department. So there we go. You can read the full spec in the magazine, but for the time being, I'm going to leave it there. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. Hope to see you next time.